Philippine Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon supports Senate President Vicente Sotto III's push to amend the Partyless System Act. Sotto last week said a bill was being crafted to ensure that only marginalized representatives and groups not working for the overthrow of government would be clarified or qualified to join the partyless race. Let's now talk to election lawyer, attorney Emil Maranon III. Good morning, Attorney Maranon, and thank you for joining us again in the program.
Good morning, Christian, and good morning po sa lahat na nakikinig na yung programa.
Okay, first let's put things in perspective. The partyless law, which was enacted in 1995 and took effect in 1998, does it need a lot of reform? Coming from you as an election lawyer. Okay, definitely.
Yes, I mean, it is an overhaul. Like, kailangan niyang talagang sulatin from scratch once again po. Okay. Because if you read the law, a lot of flip-flops na ginagawa ng Supreme Court as regards its interpretation is because the law was badly crafted way back in 1995. Ang daming loopholes, ang daming ambiguous provisions. And this is precisely why ang kalat ng decision ng Korte Suprema as regards the partyless system.
Is it because of the law or is it also because of the provision in the Constitution?
No, the Constitution is supposed to give like a general guidelines as regards the partyless system, but yung detalye po niya na dapat nakasulat po doon sa batas. But unfortunately, the law has been badly crafted na simula noon hanggang sa case na atong paglaom noong 2013, paiba-iba po yung interpretation ng Supreme Court. In fact, in the latest decision of the Supreme Court in atong paglaom, it basically allowed everyone. It's like an open for all system na hindi na kailangan na marginalized and underrepresented ka for you to participate in the partyless system. Because of this error of the Supreme Court in interpreting the law, we end up now with a partyless system na occupied na actually ng regular na politiko natin. In fact, yung mga nag-graduate na po doon sa pagtakbo as congressman, they would end up as partyless representatives. In fact, extending their term beyond doon sa three-term limit na sinet na constitution.
Okay, but don't you think that the latest ruling of the Supreme Court was actually faithful to the provision of the Constitution? Because the Constitution itself does not limit groups that will participate in the partyless race to be part of the marginalized sector. Diba? It allows regional and national organizations. Nakalagay yun sa ano eh.
Yes, but if you're going to read actually the actual deliberations of the members of the Constitutional Commission, it is very apparent there that the intention behind the partyless system is to give representation and voice to the marginalized and underrepresented. Because po, pag inalaw natin na pumasok yung regular politician dito, meron na po sila doong boses under the regular district seat po sa Kongreso. And precisely yun po yung purpose ng partyless system is to reserve slots for those sectors na hindi expected na mananalo under a regular election po.
Yeah, but of course that was also part of the debate and I think the non-sectoral representation proposition actually won that argument, right? That's why we were left with that specific constitutional provision. Now, I'd like to go to this proposal coming from Senate President Vicente Sotto III. Number one, he wants to clarify once and for all that those that will participate in the partyless election would actually be part of the marginalized sector. Will this actually correct this this glaring error that we're talking about here?
Yes. In fact, what happened as a background dun sa nakikinig po, way back in 2013, under the chairmanship of Sixto Brillantes, the COMELEC actually pushed for this interpretation na ini-include po ni Senate President Sotto ngayon. So according to the COMELEC way back in 2013, the partyless system should be made exclusively for the marginalized and underrepresented. Apart from that po, the nominees of the partyless organization must also come from a marginalized or underrepresented sector. It's not enough na advocate lang po siya. So if you look at the interpretation of the COMELEC, this is exactly what Senator Sotto is trying to insert in his proposed bill. Unfortunately, when the COMELEC disqualified almost three-fourths of the registered partyless organizations, they went up to the Supreme Court in that case of Atong Paglaom. And unfortunately, the Supreme Court reversed the COMELEC. So, ni-reverse ng COMELEC and basically made the partyless system open and free for everyone now.
Which again would go against the spirit of the party-list law itself, because here the party-list law wanted to provide better opportunities for those that would not otherwise win in district elections, right? Kasi nga, you're talking about big money, big influence, the oligarchs, the political dynasties. Since the party-list organizations or the marginalized sector representatives would not be likely to beat those people running in district seats, right?
Correct.
Against an available avenue or venue, which is a party-list race, which, of course, over the years has also been hijacked by these political dynasties. So that part of Senator Soto's proposal would actually clarify what the party-list law should be all about once and for all. But don't you think that would also require amending the Constitution? Attorney Maranon?
Yes, I think that amendment by Senator Sotto would clarify the ambiguities. And in fact, ang effect po nito would basically to supplant the decision of the Supreme Court doon sa atong paglaog po. So basically, magkakaroon po ng legislative clarification as regards the true meaning and interpretation ng party list system natin po. And I think this is very important because kami pong mga abogado, may medyo naguguluhan na rin because every election may paiba-ibang interpretation as regards to the party list system. And we hope that with this law, matanggal na po yung ambiguity and ambiguity doon sa batas. And we finally get like a final idea on what a party list system should really be.
So no need to amend the Constitution? Just the law?
There is no need to amend the Constitution. I think a mere amendment of Republic Act 7941
Attorney Maranon? Okay, you're still there? Okay.
Yes.
Let's talk about the second part. I think this is also equally important, if not even more important, in terms of reforming the party list law. Because part of the proposal coming from Senator Sotto is that among the grounds for refusal of a party list group's registration before the Commission on Elections, he mentioned directly or indirectly participating in acts detrimental to the best interests of the government, to overthrow the government or diminish its powers, or to be associated with any means to rebels or those designated and or prescribed as terrorist persons or groups under the anti-terrorism law. What do you think of this particular proposal, this proposed amendment, especially the wording that was that were included here, the words or the phrases that were included here? For instance, detrimental to the best interest of the government. I mean, isn't that also quite vague? And this could also be dangerous in terms of keeping legitimate organizations out of the party-list system by mere suspicion that they are linked to, let's say, the underground movement.
Okay. Unang-una po, if we read Republic Act 7941, which is the Party-List System Act, there are existing grounds for disqualifying a party-list organization. So one of them is advocating violence or unlawful means to achieve its goals. So if you read that, it's actually very vague and quite pervasive in terms of scope. And this amendment of Senator Sotto would actually specify what is the meaning of unlawful and violent means of achieving its goals. But again, as you have mentioned, ang iyong threshold, which is detrimental to the state or to the government, is quite vague. And ang tanong po dyan is, will the COMELEC, which has the jurisdiction over the question of disqualification, would have actually the competence or the skill to actually determine whether something is detrimental against the government? So medyo problematic for me.
What does that mean in the first place, di ba?
Yes, exactly. So detrimental in terms of like range, ano yung range na detrimental which should be sufficient for a party's organization to be disqualified or canceled by the COMELEC is something that is quite dangerous din kasi baka nag-rally ka lang, tinanggal ka na, di ba?
Okay. How about the second part, yung nakalagay ano? Or to be associated by any means to rebels. I mean, by any means. In the current political environment that we have now, don't you think this could also be dangerous? I mean, people are getting tagged or red-baited left and right. And this could actually provide an opening for the government to go after its critics so that the next batch of congressmen, for instance, would have very minimal opposition.
Yes, this is quite, it's not just quite, but it's actually very dangerous because there's no crime by association. Either you commit it or you don't commit it. So to say na one is committing, for example, rebellion or insurrection by association is something unheard of in our context as a criminal justice system, you know? So parang never ko pang narinig na there is such an act which would actually be a ground for disqualifying a particular group, meaning crime by association. I think there's no such thing. And I think if this will be raised before the Supreme Court, I think this will be surely declared unconstitutional by the Supreme Court.
Okay, Attorney Emil Maranon, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Maraming salamat. Thank you.